my channel Real Mom and I'm Dr. Nandini. Today I'll be showing you some daily practice worksheets. You can also call them DIY worksheets, but yes, I have taken out the printouts, but I'm saying it DIY because when you visit any website or free worksheets, there are so many worksheets, like thousands of worksheets are there. So sometimes we get very confused that which worksheet should we take, which not. So I have selected few worksheets which I think are good for toddlers, and here I'm not mentioning any age. You can go for 2+ to 5 years because these all worksheets are mixed. Every child has their own caliber. If you feel that you do not have time right now, you cannot draw them, then you can simply comment here in my video and you can mention your email ID and you can write worksheet, or I'll mention my mail ID in the description box and over here also it's coming. You can mail me and you have to just write that you require the worksheets, and the worksheets which we are showing you right now, I'll send all the PDF files, soft copies to you, and you can simply take out the printouts and they are not charged. They are just free of cost. So now let's start with the video. So the first worksheet which we have over here is ABCD tracing. This is the simple ABCD tracing. If your child knows how to write, you can definitely go for this worksheet and you can draw it at home also. Then the next is odd one out. It's a basic concept which you can teach from 2+ to 5 years, anyone. The child who doesn't know about odd one out, you can start teaching them, and it's very fun to, you know, do this worksheet. The child has to simply like strawberry, strawberry, banana, strawberry. So which is the odd one? So banana is the odd one. So you can just ask the child to circle it or to color the odd one or to color the ones which are more in quantity. So this is the fruit presentation. You can draw it at home or you can take a printout. Then next is circle the matching lowercase letters in each row. So what here we have to do, when you have taught your child about uppercase and lowercase and you have taught them the recognition, you can simply go for these type of worksheets so that you will get to know that they are not doing a random guess when you are teaching them on the book. You are drawing like A, then small a. So sometimes they just make a pattern in their mind and they know that after A, this will be surely small a, which mom is showing regularly. So you can give a mixed worksheet like this, and now you can ask them like, this is B, so where is B? So they will circle B so that the recognition will be very, very strong. Then the next thing is count and match. Here I'm taking mixed worksheet, as I told you, count and match. It's solving here three purpose. First is counting, which the child has to count the dots. Then is the number presentation in words, and then the addition. So for example, if I take this one, then there is 5 dots and 2 dots. If the child is not familiar with the dice presentation of numbers, he will count it. Give him time to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then here 1, 2. Then you ask the child to count it all together and it will come 7. So they have to read it and then they have to connect it to 7. Then the next thing is addition. Addition and addition, I just love this worksheet because it's so simple and so fun that there are two dice over here. One is having 1 dot, one is having 2 dots. So we will ask the child that 1+2 dots, how many? They will count the total and they will write the number. So this is a very, very basic worksheet and I find it very easy for the child to start. Like if you are teaching them addition, because whenever we are done with the numbers, the reverse counting, we start first with the addition because addition is more easy than subtraction. So this is a really, really nice worksheet which you can go for. For example, there are 2 dots here, there are 3 dots. So 2, 3, 4, 5. So you will say 2+3 is equal to, the child will write 5. So like this you can teach them. I am here using pencil. You can ask them to use crayon, sketch pens, whatever they are comfortable with. But yes, try to avoid sketch pens. You can use this type of crayons or you can use color pencils or simple pencils. This is the worksheet of addition, and this is a little bit different from the earlier one. Here we are having the number presentation also and the dice presentation also. When you are done with the previous one and you have shown them the dots presentation on the dice, then you can simply tell them that it's a proper method of addition. It's a proper math concept in which we have to do the addition, and you can show the dot and the number all together so that they will get more clear about the concept of addition. And you can go for additions only when they are done with their total concept of numbers, like reverse, reverse counting, and they can quantify, they can count the numbers, they can observe the numbers, they can recognize, they can write, then only you go for additions. Don't be in a hurry to go for addition and subtraction in early ages. Then I guess this is a repetitive worksheet. Then the second one is the other one is the lowercase alphabets. If you are done with the uppercase and you are teaching them writing, then again you can make a scenery like this and you can write the lowercase. So it will be very attractive and they would like to do it, because our basic motto is to make the worksheet interesting so that they don't feel bored and they want to do it. And the worksheets on every page should be very short. You should not keep all together everything on one plate. So this is the concept over here. Then now we are having the odd one out here. I have taken out this printout because I find it very, very useful. Here we are solving 2-3 purpose. We are obviously teaching them odd one out. Then here you'll get to know the recognition also, when the child will say, okay, this is odd. So you will ask, which number is this? So we will ask him to circle the 8. Now we have the circle the biggest object in each row. For this you can start as early as possible because this is a very fun concept which you can teach them at home also. But like this you can make a worksheet, and in one line you can ask the biggest, in one you can ask the medium, in one you can ask the smallest. So it's not that whatever is written on the worksheet we have to go that way. But yes, of course, you can ask all the three in one worksheet if the child is clear about the three sizes. Or else you can, like this only, you can start for the biggest and the smallest, and then one worksheet for medium, and then you can go all together. So, sorry for the noise which is coming from outside, because Samarth is playing with his father. So it's very difficult for, you know, small child to ask them to keep quiet. We are making video. Cut and paste each lowercase letter next to its matching uppercase. So this is these are the uppercase, and I have to cut these letters and the kid has to paste it in front of the lowercase. Uppercase, lowercase. And in this, if your child is good at writing, then you can skip this cutting part and pasting, and you can simply ask them to write it. So it can work either ways. If you can jumble up and you can ask them to paste it. Then we come to the ordinal numbers. So here you teach the child after 1, 2, 3, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. And then you can ask them, okay, you color the 2nd ladybug. Okay, you color the 4th butterfly. You color the 3rd bee. So like this, you can ask them to do the worksheet. And here I am showing you a lot of worksheets. It's not that you have to make them do all together. You can keep them, and like one day you can go for numbers, one number worksheet. One day you can go for number worksheet, one day you can go for alphabet worksheets. So now circle the picture that is different. So again, it's odd one out. You can ask them to circle, you can ask them to color. And when you are taking out printouts like this, then of course ask what the picture is. Like if this is honeybee, then you ask the child also that what is this? Which insect is this? So this will enhance their other knowledge also. So we should always find that in one worksheet, we should always find questions for the child, so that if they get up after 2 or 3 worksheets also, we will find that they have learned a lot. And I will surely mail you. You just commonly in the comment section your mail ID and you write worksheet. So I'll get to know that you want the worksheet, and I'll send you the PDF free of cost, no charges. I will send you all the worksheets soft copy and you can take them out. So now we come to the counting and writing. Here there's a cake. You can draw this at simply at home also. You have to just draw the candles and the child has to count and write it in front. Like this is one, so child will write one. One we teach in two pattern, one like this or one like this. Now the next is again the lowercase and the uppercase. The child has to trace, simple worksheet. And now this is the shapes worksheet. This is very good. I find it very nice. They have taken many shapes, like triangle is there, circle is there, rectangle, square, curves are there. So this is very nice. And like this, if you take out printout of this type of worksheet, then take out 3-4 printouts, same. And ask the child to draw daily. So you will see that slowly, slowly they will get to know the scenery and they can draw it without this dot, dot, dot. Then this is again how many, just count and write. Before going to edition, you can go for this type of worksheet, and then you can go for the dies edition worksheet. You can also make a DIY dies at home, and then you can ask the number from the child. So yes, we are done with the worksheets. I think I have shown you around more than 15 worksheets, and they are really, really nice. If you like them, then you make them at home. They are very easy, super easy.
Once you see someone doing these worksheets, then you follow me on Instagram. So that's all for the worksheets, and if you like them, then please share it, like it, and subscribe my channel. I always ask you to subscribe my channel so that if my subscribers will be more, it will give me encouragement that yes, I am making good content which is helping your child in learning in daily fun activities, and I can think more and I can make more content also. And I have made so many DIY worksheets which I have made on my own. So if you want to check them, also go in the I button or in the description link or on my channel. You will find all the DIY worksheets, all the learning folders which I have made for kids, which you can also make easily at home. So stay home, stay safe. Bye.